हेलो ऑल, वेलकम टू डे 3 ऑफ आईक्यूएसई पीजीडीएवी कॉलेज वेबिनार सीरीज बेसिक। आई एम शिखा मिनानी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर पीजीडीएवी कॉलेज, एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट मेकिंग द वीडियोस यूजिंग अ सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड मूवली। नाउ व्हाट ऑल वी कैन डू यूजिंग मूवली? मूवली कैन बी यूज्ड टू शेड्यूल आवर क्लास लेक्चर्स। वी कैन मेक देम फील अलाइव by making use of the motion graphics. We can even use the voiceover. We can record our own video. And there are already certain predetermined templates, clips, images, and videos that we can make use of. So let us get started. For that, just type on your browser, Moovly. Now, this is what would open, Moovly.com. Click on this and if you are using it for the first time, then you need to sign up. So let us open it and see how it looks. Alright, so here in case of Moovly, we have various options. You can see how to create, right, the business videos, education videos and personal videos. They also give you the option regarding their pricing, because there are certain features in Moovly which are free for educators and teachers like us, and the others are pro and which have to be purchased. Then for this, we need to sign up and we'll go to get started. Now when I go to get started, it asked me for the account, whether mine is business, education or personal. It's better that we click on education, because for the educators, it has various options that it provides us. So I'll click on this teachers and explain a lesson topic, because that is what I want to do with my students. Now it says easily create educational videos, because I have registered as a teacher. And you can see these are the things that you can do. Engage your class with video assignments, from free individual plans to group plans for classes, articles. So you can read all this now and you can start creating by going to sign up. But as I already have my account here, so I need not sign and I simply go to the dashboard. This is my account where I have already registered, and you can see that these are few projects that I have made using Moovly. Alright, so all the projects are automatically saved on the Moovly desktop. Now let us get started. For that, you have to click on this create project. So as soon as I click on create project, it asks me for two options, whether you want to start from scratch or you want to use an existing template from Moovly. I want to decide from myself as to how my video should look. So I will start from the scratch. So I'll click on new project, and this is how the Moovly screen appears. The screen is quite similar to the one that we had in OBS, because both are basically for making the videos. Now here I'll click on no thanks, and it asked me you can restart the walkthrough. So they can also provide you a tutorial, but as I am already teaching you how to make a video, so I'll simply skip this. But if at any point of time you feel like taking some help, then you can always click on this help button. Alright, so let us first understand this Moovly page. Here the first thing is, on this left side we have this library. In this library, now the benefit is that you already have certain clips, images, audios and videos which are free and which you can use easily on your Moovly account. So this is the first thing which everybody would be frequently using whenever they are making their video, and this is known as the library. Now this white thing that we have in the middle is basically our stage or our canvas. So this is our canvas where we would be visualizing and making our video. So here on my screen, everything that I would be doing and what I want to project to my students would be appearing here. Then here in the bottom, this is the timeline. Alright, so this is the timeline where I can make the adjustments as to what thing should appear first and what thing should appear later. I can also add the animations to that. So this is very important, which is the timeline. On this right side, we have the stage properties, right? So you can resize the shapes that you put in here in your screen. You can change the color of your screen. You can change the color of the text that you have written. So all that would be done from the properties. So on the whole, we have four things: the library, we have our screen or stage, we have on the bottom our timeline, and on our right we have the properties. Now the first thing that we need to do whenever we are starting our project is we need to give it a name. So let us just click on this top. You have this pen or pencil. We need to click on this and we will give it a name. So we will write FDP3, right? Because this is our FDP3. So we have given a name to it. Now let us get started. And for that, we'll go to the library. In the library, you have various options. See, these are the various options. The first option is your library. So this is my personal library. I can save various images here, which later on I can use for my videos. We'll learn in our next video how we can upload the images, text and the audios here. First, let us see what are the free things that are available to us. So wherever you are seeing this pro, these pro you won't be able to use until and unless you have paid or you have subscribed to Movie. So what I would be using is, I would be using the other free options, and for the teachers, we have various options. Okay, so what we'll do now is, we'll first of all go to clips. So let us get started, and let me first show you the motion graphics. In the motion graphics, we have certain motion graphics, which means that whenever I insert it in my screen, they would be moving. Alright, so I can take anything. So whatever you want to select, you simply select that and its preview would be visible to you here in the properties. So whatever you select here, its preview would be available to you here. So you can see how it looks. Right, so this is how it will appear. See, this is how it will appear. Now, whatever you want to enter, you simply have to just click on that and you drag it on your screen. Click on OK. Right, so this is how it will appear. I can also resize it. So let me reduce the size and I will put it here. Alright, so you can increase or decrease the size of the motion graphic. You can insert various graphics. Let me put it here. Alright, and let me drag something else here. So I have two things here and both of them would be appearing in my account. Now, I want to insert a text also. So for that, on this above ribbon, you can see add text. Just click on this add text and wherever I click, you can type your text. So let us type, let us all pray for Mother Earth. Right, so you can type anything over here and you can select it, and from the properties thing you can change it to bold. You can also change the text color. Suppose I want to have some other color, so you can also have that. You can change the font size. Alright, so we can change the font size. And we can also change the background color. See, here we have this background color. Right now it is white. If I want to change it, I can go and I can click on any color and then click on this big window which has come. So as soon as I click here, it has changed, but I want to change it for my whole thing. So let me click on the screen because the text was selected. So I click here. And I go to stage properties and I go to background color. All right. So in the state properties, in the background color, I can select this. I will click here and the whole background has changed. Let us go back to our text. So as soon as I click on text, you can see that in the properties, the text properties has opened. So there are three things now. The stage properties, which is the whole stage, my whole screen. The next is the template properties. And the third is the text properties. All right. In the text properties, I can change the font. Let us increase it to 30. And I can change the color and the background color of the text. Let me change it to this. All right. So this is how it will appear. Now, come to this timeline. In this timeline, you will see that I have added three things. What are the three things I have added? First is, I have added a text which is written in this yellow ribbon. Second is the fire banner, the fire which is here. And the third is the earth rotation. So these are the three things that I have introduced. Now, all these three things are starting from the beginning, which means that all of them would start at the same time. But you can change it also. It is up to you. You will decide what thing should appear first, what thing should appear second, and what thing should appear later on. So I want that in the beginning, I only want to have the rotating earth. So I'll keep it here and then I'll click on this fire banner and I will simply drag it. I will drag it so that this fire comes a little later, because I want to show that earlier there was the earth and then it started burning because of the action of the human being. And third, I want to have this text later on. So you can drag it and you can also increase or decrease the size. Suppose I want to reduce the time for which the earth is rotating. So I can simply decrease or increase it. Or if I want that throughout the video, the earth should keep on rotating and the fire should also be there. So all of them would end at the same time. And the last thing in this video is how to add the animation. So these are the three things. Wherever you want to add the animation, you click on that. So I have clicked on this earth rotation and click on add animation. Now in add animation, there are various things. Whether you want a hand to just bring this earth, you want to move and transform, exit and enter. So let us go to enter and let us go to bounce in. So now what will happen? You will see these two dots which have come here. So this is the duration of the animation what will be there. So during this time, the earth would be bouncing in. If you want to increase the animation, you can do that. You can increase the size. All right. Similarly, you can also have it in the fire. So I have clicked on this fire banner alpha. So wherever you want to have the animation, the first thing is that you have to first click on that. Okay. So just remember this. And then you go to add animation. Let us see. I want to go to move and transform and I want to zoom in. So this is the animation. Let us go to the last animation, which is the text. Again, add animation. And I want a hand to just place it here. So it is the hand which will drag in. All right. And I can increase the size. So this is my video, which I have made with Moovly. This is a very initial video. Let us see how it would appear. So I'm just starting it. Alright, so this is how the video is made using Moovly. You can see how the earth came in and how the fire zoomed in and zoomed out and how the text came in later. So you can decide how you want your video to appear. I hope you all like this and we'll meet in the next video. Thank you so much. Hello all, welcome to this second video where we are making the interactive videos using Moovly. So as you remember, in our first video, we made this where we used the text and a moving graphic which had the earth and the fire. Now let us see how you can save this particular video. The one benefit of Moovly is that whatever you make on Moovly, it is automatically saved on your Moovly account. But still, if you want to be doubly sure, you can click on this save button here. So you can see that this saved icon has come. Now this video is saved to my Moovly account. So I'll go to my Moovly dashboard, which is my homepage of Moovly. And this is the video that I made, remember, using FTP 111, FTP 3. So let us see how it will appear as the full screen. So I'm just clicking it. And this is how the video would appear. So you can also edit your project. If some editing is left, you can again click on that. You can edit your project. You can publish it to Facebook, Movie Gallery, or to YouTube directly. Then you can have the details edited if you want to change something. Right, so that can also be done. I don't want that to happen. So I'm going back. Let me go back. You can also download it as the video, which you can use later on to pass it on to your students via the Google Classroom or the YouTube link. Now let us see what more can be done using Moovly. How we can add the audios and the already existing clips. So I'll go to create project again because I'm making a new project. I will click on new project. And I'll click on no thanks because I don't want them to tell me the whole story. I know it already. Now, go to library, and in library you have these various options. Alright, we have already selected the motion graphics. Okay, so you also have various photos that you can select. These are the various photos that you can select. You can simply drag it over here. Just click it and drag it. Alright, so this is a photo over here. Let us see what else we have. We also have a doodle marker. So this is the doodle marker. Alright, so a doodle would appear. There would be a notebook on which I can write something. So I'll again drag it over here. So this is the notebook clip, which is the doodle marker. I want it to come later, or let me keep it here and take this people talking later so that it is not mixed. Alright, so this is my notebook clip. And let us start it first, then I'll show you how you can edit it. So what we have done, we have started this doodle making and you just pause it over here. Okay, because when you'll pause it, you can click it twice and you can write, "Welcome to the flipped classroom." So the text also can be written according to your choice. Alright, so this is one thing. Let us go back and see how it appears. So this is the doodle where we have written, we have changed the text, and after this our image of people would appear. Now after this, if I want to record my own voice, so for that what you can do is you can go to this record option, record audio, and others are paid, I cannot use that, so I have to go to record audio. And as soon as I click over here, whatever I am speaking on my microphone would be recorded. So let us start. Hello and welcome to a new lecture. Today we would be studying about insurance. Hello and welcome to a new
lecture. So this is how it will appear.
And I can give it a name. I can give it a name and I can save it. So what will happen now? When I'm doing this, all this audio would be saved in my personal library. Alright, so all this audio would be saved in my personal library. It would take some time, and after that, let us see how it is saved. Let us go to library, and here in my personal library, you can see all the recording that I have done. As soon as you bring your mouse, your cursor over here, you can see the different names that we have given. So this was the audio. I can bring it, I can drag it here. Okay, so if I go ahead, this is the audio that I have recorded. I will bring it here along with the picture. I want to have it along with this picture of the businessman. So let us see where it is. So we'll adjust it with this. So it is your choice how you want to adjust the audios and the videos. You can make your personal library. How to do that? For that, go to libraries, click on personal library, click over here and go to upload media. So when I go to upload media, it asks me to upload files. You can import from Google Drive also, but let me upload certain files that I have saved on my desktop. So I'll select certain pictures. Alright, so these are the pictures that I have selected and added to my personal library. Okay, so the files have been added. You can see that there are two images that I have added to my personal library. So you can add various images to your personal library and then you can use them to create your lectures or videos for your students. So let me drag this here. So when I have dragged it, then here you can see that here's the waterfall, right? So we can have it after this. So you can make various options. You can do this and let us see how the final product would look. So for that, I'll go to my dashboard so that I can see. So let us see how the video that I have made would appear. Hello and welcome to a new lecture. Today we would be studying about insurance. Alright, so this is how we create a video using Moovly. Now one last thing, for that we'll go back to create project, go back to new project, and what we can do over here is, no thanks, okay, and the library is just loading. So this is our library. You can also have an enlarged view of the library. So if I click on this, just a second, so I can have an enlarged view of my library. And alright, so you can select these pictures. So these are the pictures which are free. You can choose it from here. So I'll just cross it and my normal library would appear. Now let us start with something. So I'll take this bicycle and I will drag it over here. So this is the bicycle and I can change its color. As you know that we can try and change the color. Alright, so we have changed the color and we can also flip it. So here you can see these two signs, flip horizontal and flip vertical. So we can also change the position, you can see, right? And if you want to add the animation, there are two ways. The one that I told you in the first video, and here also you can click on the, you can just simply right click and there is this add animation. You can go to enter and it is fly in. Alright, so it will simply come inside our preview. Now this is clip one. Okay, you can add various clips over here, though it is better that you have one clip in one particular Moovly video because it's simple to manage, but still you can add on more clips. So for that you can go to add clip. Let us add clip. So now you can see that we have this clip 2, right? And in this clip 2 now you can add anything that you want. Suppose I want to add this. This is the ball in my clip 2. Alright, so I can similarly add the videos, the clips and the images. And if I want that clip 2 should come after clip 1, so we can have it like this. So first clip 1 would be there, then clip 2 and then clip 3, 4. So it would be a big video and a one whole session of my flipped classroom. Let us see how the completed video appears. Alright, so the bicycle has come in, it has faded in and now clip 2, which is our ball. So this is how you can make the videos using Moovly. I hope you would be using this in your classrooms. Thank you so much.